Ask an atheist.
Excellent. Yes. I got a question for you.
Okay.
Where do you get truth from evolution?
Pardon me?
Truth.
Truth?
Yeah. You guys believe in truth?
Sure.
Where do you get truth from evolution?
What do you mean? I have a hard time.
How about, you define truth?
Truth is something that we all agree upon that's independently verifiable, falsifiable.
It also means either for or against something. So if we're saying that we accept evolution as the best explanation for how we got here, giving that life already existed, this is where.
I think it's easier if we do it. Who wants to engage?
I'll go.
Okay, so you're saying truth is what is agreed upon. So if you have an opinion of something and I have an opinion of something, mm-hmm. and they differ,
that's an opinion.
How do we determine which is true? If you say something is true and I say the opposite is true, how do you determine which is true?
Things that are independently verifiable, that'd be a good place to start.
Okay, verifiable. Variable.
Right.
So something to be verified that would assume that it's true.
So if that light pole there, say I don't see it, but you see it, then we ask Rob and we ask everybody else, is it there or not?
Okay, so let's back up a bit. Would you agree that your definition of truth is truth is real? What is real, independent of what people think about it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So truth is that which corresponds to reality. You have a correspondence theory of truth.
I have a what?
A correspondence theory of truth.
I don't know what that means.
That means truth is that which corresponds to reality. Truth is that which is real. Is that fair?
Sure.
Okay.
Well, things that are independently verifiable.
Well, the thing is,
there's things that we know that we can't see with our eye, but we know
right,
that there are planets,
right,
even though we can't see them with our eye.
Right. But the thing is, you cannot know something to be true which might be false. It has to comport with reality.
Okay. Well, what are you getting? What are you getting at?
Well, I'm just having a conversation with you. I want to know. So, the truth is what is real. Now, in order to determine what's real, you use your senses and reason. Is that fair?
Sure, and we use inferences. And
how do you know your reasoning is valid?
There, a lot of times they're not.
I know, but that's not what I'm asking. How do you know it's ever valid?
How do I know it's ever valid?
Right.
Well, I go on evidence and I go on reason.
I'm asking you how you know your reasoning is valid. You say you go on reason.
Right.
You don't see a problem with that?
How do I know my reasoning is valid?
Right.
Because I don't exceed what the standards of evidence that I see exist.
So
if I drive down the road, I don't just assume cars aren't coming and run through the red lights, you see?
Well, let me ask you a question. Would you agree that there's people on this earth who have invalid reasons?
That have invalid
reasons?
Yeah, but please just tell me where this is going.
Well,
we're
going on a logical progression here. There are people on this earth who have invalid reasoning. Would it not follow that those people cannot know that they are such people? Because you would need valid reasons.
Sure, there's people in sanitariums that think they're Napoleon, but they're not.
How do you know you're not
there's
such
people,
a person?
There's people, Third Eagle of the Apocalypse thinks he's the co-prophet.
How do you know that you're not such a person?
Because doesn't think he's the, because you're right. You might be talking in a case of solipsism.
So I'm asking you, how do you know that you're not such a person? You don't know that, right?
You
could be strapped face down to a bed in a psych ward right now.
There's also...
But this could all be fake.
Well, I could independently verify that I'm not
Hang
Napoleon, right? Right?
Let me ask you
also
a question. I'll give you a scenario.
Very, very, very improbable that he is.
I'll give you a scenario. There's a mansion with 1,000 rooms in it, right?
Okay.
In all of these rooms, the people are strapped face down to a bed and they have wire and they're being fed thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Only in one of those rooms are their reasoning faculties proper.
Right.
Now, I'm asking you how you know something to be true.
Because it's not independently verifiable and falsifiable.
Hold on, wait.
Let me finish.
Can I interject? Okay.
I'm asking you how you know something to be true, and you can't tell me that you're not in that room. So therefore...
And you tell him that you're not in that room.
Oh, yes, I can.
Prove it.
Well, hang on a second.
That's a very, very...
Yeah, one more time. So you can't determine that you're not in that room, so you can't tell me what's real, and therefore you can't know what's true. You can't know anything according to your worldview. That's what scripture says.
If you start from that point of view, you can't live in reality.
Okay, is that true, sir?
Yes, it is.
What is true in your worldview?
If you start from a point of view that the truth only exists in your head...
That's not what I'm saying.
That's basically what you're saying. You're in a sanatorium. You don't know if you're in it or not. That's
what
you're
saying. That's not what I'm saying. How you know anything to be true unless you start with...
I can only rely on the senses.
Okay, is that true?
Yes.
How do you know your senses are valid?
I don't know.
Okay, so you
Neither
can't
do you.
Okay, now listen to what this gentleman is saying. He says, I can't know my senses are valid. Mm-hmm. But he says, either can you. How do you know that if you can't know anything?
How do you know that I don't
know? Okay, that's fine. I would say...
No, you're talking a lot right now for the camera, but you're making absolutely no sense.
Okay, since you assume that there's a sense.
We're talking, right? How do you know I'm talking to you right
now? How do I know that? I use my senses.
Oh, reasoning. But you hear it first.
Right.
There's your senses. How do you know you're hearing it?
How do I know that?
Yeah.
I use my sense and everything. Give it to me from God.
You can't. You no. You're making up something in your head. Yes, that's absolutely true. Because I hear you through my ear. I make sense of it.
You believe in absolute truth, sir. What is absolute truth?
I don't believe in absolute truth.
You're
putting things into my. You're making absolutely no sense.
You don't. Is that absolute truth?
No. Talk to me.
How can you say
he's running away?
That there's UFO wreckage.
So you don't believe in absolute truth?
No.
Okay. Is it absolute truth?
That's no absolute truth.
Try to make sense when you say so.
Obviously not. You don't even argue it.
His tape being in the adult
tape. That's why it says. That's why it says the fool has said the church has no God.
Like, well, the Bible
is
the
children's table.
Well, we know the Bible's wrong, right?
You gotta argue with the adults.
Well, I guess I'm all out of this.
Jesus. Go there.
Why don't you? No, hey, relax. He's making no sense. Why are you getting excited about it? Why don't you tell me why you think God tells you anything at all?
You know how I know God exists?
Yes.
Yeah, the same way you do.
No, I don't know.
So, I want to hear this.
I've got a question.
No, I would like to.
Please explain to me how you know God exists.
Same way you do, sir.
How do we know?
By his revelation.
Okay. What revelation?
The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
The Bible says, how do you know it's true?
Wait, no, sir, I want to hear
him. If you want me to answer the question,
okay.
I'm going to answer it. The Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. All the prayers of wisdom and knowledge are hidden in Jesus Christ. What that basically means is that unless you start with God, you can't know him. But now, everybody, hang on a second, one more time. Everybody here is making knowledge claims. And I ask you how you can know things, and you say I can't know anything. And exposes
know?
That you do know that God exists when you make knowledge claims.
You read the Bible through your senses. You told me I can't be sure about senses.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying you need to appeal to God in order to make sense.
Which God?
What God? How do you know? You need to perceive it through your senses.
I thought you were an alien.
But go ask those guys over there. I've got an encyclopedia of the God.
So they're saying there's many gods?
No,
according to religious,
we say we don't know. You claim knowledge. We say we don't know.
The gods of the nation.
Go ask the Muslims over there.
They will argue for a different God. Yeah.
And I'd be happy to. I'll go to their table next. Sir.
Right. Yeah, but see, I'm standing here, and they're arguing for one God.
Right.
I've got the Muslims down here that argue for another God.
Right.
Buddhists don't even argue for any God
but
at all.
Why are we proposing things that neither of us believe?
Because
why are you proposing
you
some
God? You're looking on your belief
there is a God.
I want to know how you account for truth without God. Okay. How you can know anything.
You're a physical human being.
Right. So you appeal to a reasoning.
Yes, I
do. How do you know your reasoning is valid, sir?
How do you know your reasoning is valid?
Well, sir, that's a two-fold fallacy.
No, it's not. You're asking someone about something that you don't explain yourself.
Well, I'd be happy to, but one more time.
If you haven't, I've been asking for the last 10 minutes.
Well, my friend was stating, I try to go to the best place.
But you use your reasoning to examine evidence. That's a vicious circle. It's self-refuting.
Really?
You assume your reasoning is valid when you go to it.
If you go into that vicious circle, then nobody can be right, ever. You or I.
But sir, you use your reasoning when you do that. You use your reasoning when you do that.
So you read the Bible and you don't use your reasoning?
I do.
Okay.
But I know that my reasoning is a gift from God.
It's a gift from God.
Okay, that's
see, that's what people say in the sanatorium.
Is that true, sir? Is it true that that doesn't work?
Can I take him apart?
Oh, you can have that.
Yeah.
Okay, one at a time, though.
So
we're going to have a conversation.
Okay, let's just have it right here.
What is truth?
Why are you asking me that question? The truth is the truth is not absolute. You're asking
is it
about
absolutely true that the truth isn't absolute?
It's not absolute.
Is that absolutely true?
Yes, that is absolutely true.
Thanks for your time.
No, hold on. You're being an idiot right now because you're just using words to make me look like an idiot. I said it on purpose.
Good job.
It is absolutely true that it's not true.
Thanks for your time.
Now think about that.
See, that's the absurdity of atheism.
No,
fool that said
the absurdity of your arguments is, would you please listen? Is that true, sir? Is that true, sir? The absurdity of your arguments is that you're coming here doubting people's senses and then saying, yes, you, hold on, let me explain. And then saying, but I don't believe, I don't use the way you reason because I got the gift from God, which is the most stupid thing anyone could say.
But that's
because,
your opinion.
Yes, that is absolutely true. There
but
you
that's
go.
That's your opinion.
No, hold on.
It's
not about my opinion or
but
not.
It is what your opinion what it's stupid, isn't it?
Look, there is absolutely no way of proving anything on this planet, right? There's absolutely
that's
true.
Absolutely true.
Oh my God. Are you going to argue about something that makes sense, or are you just going to be? Is that absolute? No.
I'm exposing the folly of your world.
Let's talk about your view, your worldview, which is the Bible, right? Which is the Word of God, supposedly. Let's talk about how you can believe in something.
Okay, go ahead. That's what the Bible says, sir. I didn't call him a fool.
You know what? Your shirt is...
Right, that's what the Bible says.
I don't care what the Bible says. I'm talking about human beings.
Right. What's wrong with that, sir, in your worldview? Is that absolutely wrong to do that?
You know, I'm not going to have a semantic discussion with you about the use of language.
You can't make sense of your objection.
My objection is that wise people shouldn't be calling other people foolish.
Who says?
That's not a very wise thing to do.
Who says? What is wisdom in your worldview? What is wisdom?
Would you please listen to people before you ask them?
But he's making an objection.
He makes one half sentence, and you're like, what is this?
What if I said a wise man is somebody who
because he's
craps
being
on the
an
floor
idiot.
And eats it.
That's why.
Why would I be wrong and you be right?
No, because he doesn't let people talk.
Okay, so you're not saying you're right.
He's like, why is this true? And you're not even done with the sentence.
He's asking you a question.
Huh?
Ridiculous.
What?
You
haven't
answered
any questions. I don't argue semantics.
You're not asking questions. He's trying to be
true for all people at all times.
What does science say about consciousness?
Hold on.
True for all people at all times.
Because you don't know yet, doesn't mean we can't
God exists.
Right. So
how do we verify? But just because
everybody knows that God exists, you verify.
Well, Let me finish.
You verify it by rejecting it. Your worldview is reduced to absurdity.
Well, first off, you're making an assumption that everybody agrees that God exists.
No, I'm not saying everybody agrees to it. I'm saying that everybody knows it.
No, they don't.
Sure they do.
Was there ever a time in your life you didn't know God exists? You were never a non-believer.
No.
Ever.
No.
Even as
you're not a non-believer either.
That's a long
well,
way
I believe I am.
No, you're not. Everybody knows that God exists because the thing is, you're having a conversation with me. You're saying something is true and false and knowledge.
Well,
that assumes that God exists.
How I know that God exists?
Well, the thing is, God has revealed himself to you. And every one of your
knowledge. How has God revealed himself to you?
God has revealed himself many ways. He's revealed himself in nature. He's revealed himself.
Wait. How has God revealed himself in nature to
you?
You're making a claim,
fine.
And I'm asking you to support it.
Okay.
So let's not go past these claims
and
just brush them aside as I agree with you.
You want to know if my worldview is true.
I want to know how God revealed himself to me in nature.
I'm going
to
tell you.
Excuse me.
I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, I'm asking.
You are trying to find out, because what I'm saying is Christianity is true, that he has revealed himself, and you want to know how I know it's true.
Yes.
You want to know how I know it's true?
I wish you'd stop asking the question
and
answer it.
I'm going to tell you. Do you know how? Your very question assumes that it's true.
No, it doesn't.
Sure it does. Because you are saying, how do you know your worldview is true? Truth assumes that
it's true. I'm not asking for that. That
sure.
isn't what I asked
you. Because my worldview says
that
you know God exists.
No. You made the claim that God reveals himself in nature.
Right.
And I asked you to verify that claim.
Are
you going to do it or not?
Sir,
please do.
Your very question verifies my claim.
No, don't ask that. Don't go back to my question. You made my question has nothing to do with it.
Is that true?
I'm questioning your claim.
Right.
Your claim is that God is revealed in nature. Back up that claim.
Your question?
No.
Yes.
Back up your claim.
I am backing it up.
Not with my question. Back up your claim.
I am backing it up. When you say to back up a claim, you're using my worldview. Because you're asking me
right.
to give a logical justification of my claim.
Yes, please
I'm
do.
I'm saying that you can't account for logic without God.
Oh, so you're not going to give me a logic. You're not going to give it to me. Give it to me.
You believe in logic, sir.
Give me your claim.
I am.
Please do.
Sir, you believe in logic.
Don't ask me questions.
Where
give
do you
me
logic without God? Your
we
questions.
Don't. My questions have nothing to do
sir,
with your claim. Give me your
question.
Give me your evidence that God is revealed.
Evidence assumes that God exists.
Show me it.
Evidence assumes
show
true.
Me it.
Sir, the very concept.
Where is it? Show me it. You won't show me it. You just want to talk about everything but you're answering the claim that God has revealed in nature.
Your question assumes my
no, it doesn't. My question, my question assumes you made a claim and I want proof of it.
I'll do it again.
Okay,
evidence assumes truth, correct? You can't
no,
have evidence
I don't agree with that.
Because you can have evidence that's false. If you did not murder somebody, there could be evidence that showed that you did.
People have claimed the world is black because when they look out, it looks black.
Could there be evidence to prove that you did something you didn't do?
Okay, no. Evidence and truth are two
evidence assumes
things.
Truth. It assumes truth.
No, it doesn't.
So you can have evidence that's
we have a disagreement right there, a fundamental disagreement. Evidence should assume facts.
So facts are true.
The facts aren't necessarily true.
You can have a fact that's false.
Yes, of course.
Give me an example.
Your skin is purple.
That's not a fact.
The fact that I said that.
Yeah, but
it's a fact that I said that. It is a fact
right,
that I said that.
It's not a fact that my skin is false.
No, but
fact
it's a fact that I said it.
Right, and that's a true thing that you said that.
Right.
But the object of it, the fact, is not a fact that my skin is
right.
purple.
So
facts assume truth.
No, facts assume facts.
Okay.
That's all.
And you believe in truth.
And you're going to have to define truth.
Well, I'm asking you to define truth.
Wait, you're the one who brought up.
I'll tell you what truth is. Truth is whatever conforms to the mind of God. Okay. Truth is whatever God says. What is truth in your
If that's your definition of truth, then no, I don't believe
it. Okay, so what is truth in your world? I give you my definition.
I'm not sure I can answer that question.
That's right, but you want to say that what I believe is false.
No, I don't.
And you can't make sense of truth.
No, I didn't ever, I never said that. I asked you one thing.
Right.
I will tell you that. You made the claim. Where consciousness comes from, where knowledge comes from. You stated it was true.
Right.
You stated it was factual.
Right.
That God reveals himself in nature.
Right.
And I asked you to show me an example. And you
Your example is
repeatedly.
This is my example right here.
How is that possible?
Well, that,
this is my example.
If I went to
find the
answers,
because God, all the words already.
No, they wouldn't actually. You know anything about Hare Krishna?
I do. I talk about them all the time.
Yeah, what do they believe? By your own they that, believe that this is reality? Or do they believe that this is mind, that this is illusion? What do they believe?
They would still say, though, that we are that their God is revealing and creating.
No, they don't. Okay, Hare Krishna, don't believe this. Let me go back to my question.
I know they believe a multiple God.
That's right. So which God? I mean,
even the Bible states.
And they believe that this is my dream. But I'm interested in what you believe. Because you're trying to make truth claims and you can't come.
I'm not. No, I'm making no claims.
Is that true?
I made no claims.
Is that true?
I'm just asking you to defend your claim.
Is it true that you made no claims?
Again, one more time. Can you explain to me how God is revealed in nature?
I'm showing you. I'm giving you evidence of it right now.
I don't feel that God is in me. I don't feel that God is
right. Because you need repent of your sin against the God you know exists. The God is giving you truth and reason.
You haven't made it. You haven't made a substantial point.
I cannot convince you.
Well, then that's a pretty bad God if you can't even be convinced.
No, because okay. Let me ask you a
very powerful God.
This is a question for you. God in the Bible says you have enough evidence. How much evidence would it take you to be convinced of that God? The God in the Bible says you have enough evidence. The God in the Bible says you have enough evidence. How much evidence would it take to convince you that that God exists?
Well, what evidence is there in the Bible that God exists?
I'm just telling you what the God of the Bible says. You have enough evidence. How much evidence would it take you to convince you that that God exists?
Well, evidently, it's not enough evidence because it hasn't worked on me.
But this God says you already know that he exists. You have enough evidence.
Well, I think he might be wrong.
When you stand before him,
I don't think you will stand before him. You haven't made a strong enough claim that that's going to happen.
Sir, your question assumes the truth of my claim.
The only question I asked was to show me evidence that God is revealed
evidence
in nature.
Assumes that he has been.
Yeah, well, no.
The very
I know, and you
evidence.
Haven't provided that evidence yet.
Sir, I have. Yeah. The very concept. Your question.
Well, what did he say? Because I completely missed it.
Let me do it again, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
You are asking me for evidence.
Yes.
Evidence assumes truth. It assumes
fact. That's your definition.
Well, if you want to have evidence without truth, sir, then you know that's up to you. I hope you never end up in court.
It's just in your mind.
If evidence doesn't have to be truth. See, evidence has to be factual.
Factual, I'll agree with.
Factual assumes truth. You can't have facts that are not true.
True and truth are two different things.
Okay, what is truth? You said you couldn't define it. Now you're telling me what the difference is.
Well, I think you're speaking of truth as some sort of an absolute.
Okay, what is truth?
And true just means something that's
what is
verifiable. True would, to me would be something that's
yeah,
verifiable.
It's also objective and subjective truth. Yeah.
Yeah. Is that an absolute truth? I
don't fucking know.
Well, let's not get into semantics.
You're playing games.
It's not semantics.
Because all I'm really asking is that, well, you haven't exposed the wisdom of yours yet. And I keep asking you to.
Your very question, the fact that your worldview is exposed to the truth of mine.
So, in other words, if I asked if a woman's a hooker, that makes her a hooker?
No, it doesn't.
Because that's what you're saying, that by asking a question, it becomes true. So that's not an absolute.
Well, I'll explain it to you, sir. A woman being a hooker is not the precondition for intelligibility. It's not the precondition for knowledge. However, God existing is the precondition for knowledge. As I've exposed when I've asked you what truth was, I can answer it without that. You can answer what truth is.
You did say that evidence was required to establish
the
truth.
No, what I said is evidence assumes that God exists. The very concept. You can't make sense of evidence unless you start with God.
I'm sorry.
Evidence assumes truth. Truth assumes God.
No,
you want evidence? Your question.
I don't see. I don't see evidence and assumption as being in the same parameters.
You won't see it until you're science.
What would repenting do to change my way of thinking? How would my way of thinking change
if I read Christ did not only die to save souls for eternity, he died to save the reasoning of your relationship to God? Because you can't make sense of anything.
You have great relationships now. You know what?
You can make complete sense of the entire world without the existence of Jesus.
Okay, what is true in your world?
Well, let's talk about
it. No, you haven't
listened.
Yeah, but you weren't listening.
Okay, so
I told you, when you talk about truth, you can make, it's either subjective or objective. So we talk of subjective truth or objective.
Put my word in.
Objective truth has to be something that we can verify. Okay, we would agree with that.
How do you verify?
So let's talk about history. I love history. How do you verify history?
Okay,
there's great difficulty in that. So if we talk about Julius Caesar, for example, we have statues of Julius Caesar. Do we have any statues of Jesus?
No. I think that's real question.
But what I was verifying using your
you really need, you know what, I'm
verifying, you really need to study logical fallacies.
So you believe in logical fallacies?
We don't believe
you just commit a lot of
okay, okay, so you believe in logic then, sir. Okay, this man believes in logic. Logic is universal. Logic is not
No.
Yeah, you're right. No, it's not.
Does it apply to this conversation?
Can I answer your question, please? Thank you. Logic is the way we have defined looking at the world.
Okay.
So the world is the world, regardless of what we say about it. This is the world, it is the world. There.
So you're saying logic
we
is a human construct.
We are using the word the world to describe the world.
Let me ask you a question.
So wait, I'm not finished answering. Thank you. If I step down, I'm stepping on the world, I say. Now, I'm using the word world because everybody in English speaks of it that way. That is how we communicate between us. Now, looking out, and my hand touches that, your hand touches that, my hand doesn't pass through it. Logically, it's solid. Because as a multiple people can all slap the table and none of us our hand will pass right through it. Logically, it's solid. Therefore, we have defined that as a statement of logic. And all it is a way that we define the world. As a culture, as a society.
You done yet?
Yes, that is my
this
answer.
Man says logic is a human construct. Yeah. I have a question for you, sir.
Yeah, for a universe.
I have a question for you, sir. Could the universe have both existed and not existed at the same time and in the same way before there were humans?
Who cares? Who cares?
Hang on a second. This man says human logic is a human construct.
Okay.
Before humans walked this earth.
Under my definition of logic, that is not a fallacy, and yes.
I'm asking you if the universe could have both existed and not existed before there were humans.
If there were no,
it's not a question.
That's our answer.
I'm asking for logic. Listen carefully.
Go on.
I'm going to finish answering your question before you interrupt me again.
Go on.
Thank you. Before we existed, let's say the universe existed. Before humans were ever first evolved, whatever. Okay, the universe existed. If something other than humans existed and touched it, they could touch it and make the same argument I just made.
Before there was life
maybe
on this earth.
A completely different language.
Before there was life on this earth, could the universe have both existed and not existed? So you're rambling on nonsense.
Can I finish?
Go ahead.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Then after all of the humans go extinct, let's say our sun goes supernova, and some other planet, there's some other aliens describing in a different language. I don't care how you're going to conceptualize it. Someone else could make the same argument I just made.
I'm saying no human life.
Let's go back to before humans existed. Again,
before there was human life, before life at all.
No universe.
No life. No, there is a universe, but no life yet. Right after the Big Bang, as far as you know.
Okay.
No life. Could the universe have both existed and not existed at the same time in the same way?
What are you trying to
I'm asking if logical contradictions could have actualized before there were human minds to create logic. Could the universe have both existed? Could the universe have both existed and not existed at the same time in the same way before there was life on Earth?
At the same time in the same way.
No! Here's why stars far away are still sending light to us.
It couldn't have, you're right. It couldn't have, you're right, it couldn't have. Why not? Because logic already existed in the mind of God. That's why.
That's not an answer.
So you're saying God is logical?
God is logical, yes.